Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Come on.
Glory
and with His Spirit.
As we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me for all the world.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Bless us, we pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, to always ponder in spiritual things, we may carry out in both word and deed that which is pleasing to you. Our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever. Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. James. If any one of you is in trouble, he should pray. If anyone is feeling happy, he should sing a psalm. If one of you is ill, he should send for the elders of the church, and they must anoint him with oil in the name of the Lord and pray over him. The prayer of faith will save the sick man, and the Lord will raise him up again. And if he has committed any sins, he will be forgiven. So confess your sins to one another and pray for one another, and this will cure you. The heartfelt prayer of a good man works very powerfully. Elijah was a human being like ourselves. He prayed hard for it not to rain. And no rain fell for 3.5 years. Then he prayed again, and the sky gave rain, and the earth gave crops. My brothers, if one of you strays away from the truth, and another brings him back to it, you may be sure that anyone who can bring back a sinner from the wrong way that he has taken will be saving a soul from death and covering up a great number of sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let my prayer come before you like incense, O Lord.
Let my prayer come before you like incense, O Lord.
I have called to you, hasten to help me. Hear my voice when I cry to you. Let my prayer come before you like incense, the raising of my hands like an evening oblation. Let my prayer come before you like incense, O Lord. Lord, set a guard over my mouth. Keep a watch at the door of my lips. To you, Lord God, my eyes are turned. In you I take refuge. Spare my soul. Let my prayer come before you like incense, O Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for revealing the mysteries of the kingdom to mere children. Alleluia.
Children to Jesus. yourself. For it is to such as these that the kingdom of God belongs. I tell you solemnly, anyone who does not answer, welcome. The kingdom of God is returned to all the relatives. Then he put his arms around them, laid his hands on them, and gave them his blessing. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Whenever I am called to celebrate the sacrament of the sick in somebody's home or in a hospital or here in church, I always use those words that we hear from the Apostle St. James in his first reading today. We hear those lovely comforting words. If any of you is ill, you should send for the elders of the church and must anoint the oil of the Lord in the name of the Lord and pray. The prayer of faith will save the sick man, and the Lord will raise them up again. If he has committed any sins, his sins will be forgiven. At the time of illness, the time of the need of God's presence, at the time when the Son was preparing him to die, those words are extremely comforting. Again, when I celebrate a baptism, as I will do today at 1 o'clock, I will use the words of the Gospel that we have heard this morning. Jesus telling his disciples not to stop the children from coming to him, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Jesus places his hands on them and gives them his blessing. The sacraments of the church always give us comfort in the midst of our need. The sacraments of the church always give us that beautiful welcome into his life and into his love. Let us relish these sacraments. Embrace them, and gain from them the blessings and grace that they always can give.
So we turn to the Lord with our prayers and intercession this year. We pray for the church, and all of us for you, that we may always embrace the gifts of the sacraments and live the reality of them, the change that they bring in our lives. Lord, hear our hearts.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for our world and its members. We pray especially today for the people of Ukraine. We pray for the end of war. Lord, hear our hearts.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for ourselves and our journeys of faith, the washed in the waters of baptism, we may live the gospel of the womb of less. Lord, in all us,
hear our prayer.
Pray for those who are sick in mind and body, that they may have the blessing of the sacrament of the sick. If appropriate, we pray that they may find the healing in peace. Lord, in all us,
hear our prayer.
Pray for those who have died and those whose anniversaries occur this time. They may be welcome into the kingdom of heaven. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And we ask for the prayers of heaven, Mother of grace, as we praise you.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen.
We make these and all our prayers through Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever. Blessed are you, Lord of all creation, for through your goodness we now be spread to all. Which earth has given unto you and hands and made, it will become for us the bread of life.
Yes, Lord.
The
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your offerings, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the glory of his every church.
As we celebrate your mysteries, O Lord, with the observance that is your due, we humbly ask you that what we offer in the honor of your majesty may profit us for salvation. Through Christ.
Amen.
The Lord be
with you. And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just through your beloved Son, created the human race, so also through him the great goodness you form is in you. And so it is right that all your creatures serve, and all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore we too, extolling all the angels as in joyful celebration, we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Take holy blessings, gifts, we pray, by sending down the Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have had his word to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your presence. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, through the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed St. Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, St. John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. Amen. Say this to Anne, the former by the divine teaching, who dared to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. I will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our lives, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin. Save from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Holy kingdom,
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign. The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
The love of God,
who take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Love of God, who take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Love of God, who take away the sins of the world,
grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lord.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Praise be our God to spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since many cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come and be spiritually into their hearts. Be gracious if you are there, and unite ourselves wholly to you. Never permit us to be separated from you. Grant me, great Almighty God, we may experience the effects of this salvation, which is pledged to us by these mysteries, through Christ.
Amen.
Just to mention, there is no 12 Mass next Saturday, as I will be at the right collection in the cathedral. Joining with those who are to be baptized and received into the church this Easter. So there's no Mass next Saturday, 12 o'clock. And we are due to begin stations on the cross after Ash Wednesday, and then it's one of the first stations here on Saturday. We'll be 2 weeks today, beginning at quarter past 11. There will also be stations at St. Bernadette's on Thursday mornings after the 10 o'clock. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty